Christmas.
I Christmas, so Christmas, Christmas. Christmas!
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
I love Christmas. To me, there's only two times of the year. Christmas, and fuck you when the hell is Christmas. So, to celebrate this wonderful holiday, I am going to review something Christmas-related every week of December. So, let's not waste any time. Let's get started with our very first one, Jack Frost. Poor Michael Keaton. How could such a good actor on top of the world stoop to such a low as this film? You were the Caped Crusader, now you're this hideous thing. What the hell happened? Well, let's go ahead and find out. Get on your snow boots, we're walking through a pile of shit. This is Jack Frost. So as the credits roll, we see that Mr. Jack Frost, and yes, that is his real name, is the lead in a band simply titled The Jack Frost Band.
Frosty the Snowman was a jolly happy son. He was smoking his pot belly, his two eyes were made of coal.
Jesus, these guys are making Christian rock look butch.
Frosty the Snowman was a bad.
Okay guys, this is something you would play at a kindergarten assembly. I don't think many adults would be getting into this. But then again...
It's the Jack Frost Band! They're digging it! They're loving it! We gotta sign these guys!
These guys are the hottest thing since Raffy! They're really trying to pass this off as hardcore rock? What other kids' songs you think are given the Jack Frost treatment? I'm a new teapot showing style. Here's my handle, here's my spout. When I got steamed up, hear me shout. Pull me over, tip me out. Hail Satan! Why? I just really have a hang-up that this band will be successful. I mean, they really think this would span out through a large audience? Yeah, right, and I'm in this month's edition of Entrepreneur.
Well, they'll print anything these days.
We then cut to his son named Charlie, who is just leaving school to partake in... Vietnam flashbacks. This Apocalypse Plow? Saving Private Ryan wasn't this intense.
Come on,
Diego! What did you do that for, butthead?
You gotta help it! Go! Go, 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 run!
Roaring fuck.
And it looks like he's smoking a Virginia Slim Jim.
Blow me up!
I got a present for you. Can you say brain freeze?
Brain freeze.
Motherfucker.
Way to go!
Shut up!
This is the end of it, Frost.
You will bow down before me!
So after he walks home through this live-action Christmas card, we see his father finally return to his family.
Hey, listen, my car broke down back here, and I was just wondering if I could borrow a couple of bucks till I get to a gas station.
Money? Oh, I'm sorry, my husband's a musician.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Is he any good?
Oh, yeah.
Really? You know, I also left my lip balm in the car. So, I'm out, and I think I'm feeling a little,
Chapped.
Chapped. Yeah, so I was wondering...
Will you just do each other already?! Good enough!
Charlie.
I was just resting my eyes.
You were?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Looked like you were sleeping. Didn't it look like you were sleeping?
You looked like you were asleep, Charlie.
Looked exactly like you were asleep.
Shut up! It's a family of sarcastic time wasters! Okay, so he spends quality time with his son as they build, what else? A snowman in the front yard.
Nose, come on, nose. Dad, I said nose!
Oh, I thought you said hose.
Why, Dad, you perv. After that, he tucks him into bed and says goodnight.
So?
So?
Is there anything you need to show me?
Like?
A present?
Oh, you mean like from the gig?
Yeah.
You mean like maybe those plastic swords they stick through the olives and the onions?
Oh, yeah, like for the martinis that Mom packs in my lunch.
Oh, Mom's making you martinis for lunch?
Oh my God, is every bit of dialogue just filler? Talk about something!
brought you this.
Finally!
Whoa, one of your harmonicas?
Has magic powers.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, right. I'm serious. When you play that, no matter where I am, I can hear it.
That's pretty retarded, Dad. Where'd you get that from?
I read it in Chicken Soup for the Soul.
So we hear Jack promise that he's going to be at his son's hockey game, right before he makes whoopee with Susie Snowflake here.
What do you say? You get undressed and I slip into my Batman outfit.
Well, I have to give this movie credit. It's not using the typical film cliches, but it's not really replacing it with anything else either. Here's our first standard plot point, the busy father breaking his promise because of work. You see, he misses his son's hockey game to record music that could have staged the Full House opening. But it gets even worse. Jack promises to take his family on a Christmas trip to the mountains, but is called in on a gig that could either make or break his career. So what does he do? Go to the gig, of course.
You know what? I'm gonna miss Christmas Day for sure. I mean...
Charlie, what's this? I gave this to you.
I don't want it.
Wasn't there a retarded snowman in this movie? I mean, I never thought I'd actually be asking for that, but this opening is busting my Yuletide chops!
What am I, crazy? I got a great wife, I got a great kid, I'm not living this life anymore, I'm going home.
So Jack turns around and decides he wants to spend Christmas with his family. But unfortunately, a bad storm starts to block his vision. I guess we'll just assume the worst. I mean, good lord, that was terrible! Where'd they get the transitions from, Castaway? I mean, that was kind of a huge leap movie. What, you're just trying to brush death off like a lot of those awkward Disney films? So obviously Charlie is very bummed about his father, which results in him breaking off all contact with his friends.
Cheer up, Charlie. Give me a smile.
Charlie, it's okay. I miss him too.
Okay, seriously, did Ang Lee direct this or something? I mean, we're like 35 minutes in and I haven't seen one wink of Frosty T. Blowman. What the hell is taking him so long?
Want a marshmallow?
Okay.
What do you want, one? Maybe, 500?
Thanks, Mom.
So when do you think Dad is getting back from his business trip?
You know, we should have a talk.
So Charlie makes another snowman, I guess in his father's memory, as something whimsical happens after he plays his magic harmonica. I think I'm gonna hurt!
Home.
I think I'm gonna hurl! So, yeah, this is the snowman. Pretty fucking creepy, isn't he? I mean, that's gotta be the nastiest piece of shoveled shit ever. It doesn't even look like he wants to play with Charlie as much as fucking eat him.
Charlie, it's me, it's Dad.
So Charlie hears noises outside when he... Wait a minute! What in holy hell? Is that a chained up Superman with Batman's head? What twisted, weird-ass thought that up? Michael Keaton shall come back as that! How much cooler would this movie be if he came back as that friggin' monstrosity? I can just see it now! All the kids would be running up to him and be like,
"Who are you?"
"I'm chained up Superman with Batman's head."
Holy God, that would be friggin' awesome. But no, we get Freaky the Snowman here, as he tries to greet his son, but Charlie is obviously terrified of the friggin' thing. So he gets brushed up and shoveled around, pretty much just trying to create more filler for the movie.
Oh! Talk about your separation anxiety.
Now, wait a minute for the audience to laugh at that. Okay.
Hey, you! Don't just sit there, give me a hand! Boy, I've had to put myself back together after some rough nights, but this is ridiculous.
Oh, don't worry, audience. There's more puns on the way.
Charlie's snapping out of it.
My, don't you look like my husband? Except you probably will have figured out I've been cheating behind his back for years. That's why I had to cut his brakes and send his car flying off that cliff. Well, nice talking with you, Anatomist Snowman. It feels good to tell the truth sometimes, doesn't it? Bye.
So Jack walks off into the night trying to figure out why he's there.
Man, why me? Why a snowman? I mean, could the universe really be that unoriginal? I don't know. I mean, is it the name? Jack Frost? Because